180 miles per hour shot. He comes down to the line, more crashing behind.
Junior will win in Daytona, and a big one happens behind them.
So many times we hear the big one when you come to Daytona or Talladega. It is always a possibility. We talk about the big one and Indianapolis 500 this year. Scott Dixon, a part of the big one there. Well, the Verizon IndyCar Series is on NBCSN. It's the All-American Short Track action. The Iowa 400-300 from Newton, Iowa. That's Sunday, June 9th on NBCSN. I want to take a look at the top four drivers and where they will line up for tomorrow's race. Brad Keselowski, the best in qualifying. Harvick, Stenhouse Jr., Joey Logano, Ryan Blaney, Danica Patrick, all inside the top 10 as far as starting positions for tomorrow night's race. And Ricky Stenhouse Jr., the most recent winner on the restrictor plate track. He will start sixth with Kelly.
First plate win, first cup win. And Ricky, we know that this team has such a great super speedway program. Do you think you have a car that could potentially get you back to victory lane again tomorrow?
Yeah, I think so. Our fifth third board was fast yesterday during practice. Felt good within the draft. Learned as much as we could, you know, not having a huge draft out there to really dial your car in, you know, for conditions. But you know what? I think you know, we were a little disappointed we didn't get the pole. Actually, after the first round, we were hoping to pick up a little bit to maybe be third there. We knew that 88 and 24 were going to be pretty strong, as they always are here at Daytona. So we got something we can work with, and the guys have been working really hard, like you said, on it. And it's cool to see the stat of all the Fords being up there. So hopefully we can get a Ford performance in victory lane. And, you know, Doug's been doing a great job on our engines. So we'll all try to work together and see if we can keep them up front.
Yeah, how do you guys kind of choreograph that? You're all Ford, but different teams. How does that play out during the race?
Yeah, it was nice during practice. You know, we all got together and went out and made laps, made a decent long run, you know, seeing the speed of what our cars have. Really here at the speedways, I feel like to be good, you need to figure out when you're going to pit under green and come back out all together so you lose the least amount of time. So we feel like our Fords draft really well together in a straight line. I feel like we have a lot of good speed. So if we can get on and off pit road, you know, all together and all in a line, then we can have ourselves set up for you know, some stage wins and maybe a race win, especially if it comes down to green flag pit stop. So that's the easiest time to gain or lose track position, so we'll see how it goes.
All right, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. starts sixth tomorrow. Rick?
As you mentioned, Kelly's first career win in the Monster Energy Cup Series came at Talladega Super Speedway, and there was the pass. Getting by that 18, had a little help from the 48 of Jimmy Johnson. But once he was out front, he had to protect that lead, and he did everything he could do, and it was enough. He stayed in front, was able to get his first ever Cup Series win, and it came at Talladega.
And you can see the excitement, Rick. 158 starts from a guy who had won two championships in the lower tier series at Xfinity level, came up with a lot of expectation, a lot of hope to get the victory lane quickly, took 158 starts.
Front row, Hendrick Motorsports, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Chase Elliott. That's familiar because it was just opposite of those two Daytona 500 earlier this year. Chase Elliott had won the pole. Dale Earnhardt Jr. started on the outside as we go back to row 5 through 8.
You see there in row 5 outside Danica Patrick looking for that win. This would be a great place to get it. Clint Boyer, another driver, first year with Stuart Haas Racing, a win here, guarantee a spot in the playoffs.
A little further back in the field, Denny Hamlin, former Daytona 500 winner, starting in row 9.
If I far, Kyle Larson has to come. We've seen him be so competitive at every racetrack. He's all the way back at row 11.
Well, you mentioned about coming from the back. Martin Truex Jr., I don't think has had to do it rarely at all this year, but starting back in row 13, it's going to be a challenge to get up there and compete for the win in that first stage.
And all the way back through row 20, DJ Kennington, actually his qualifying time was disallowed with the inspection. His hikes were too low, and so his time was disallowed. He will start 40th. When we come back, it's NASCAR America, Daytona International Speedway. Ian Dale Jr. will be talking about the family legacy here at Daytona. Rutledge Wood on the big fights in the Decagon after the Xfinity Series race and the Toyota drivers training with the Olympians.